I designed my education session to explore the reality behind different weight loss approaches and whether they are worth their dollar, as in can they provide us with the weight loss results they promise in the long term. My community group was Brimbank Council staff members, more specifically employees at St Albans Leisure Centre. The needs assessment was distributed online as a SurveyMonkey questionnaire. Staff members were contacted via Facebook and hard copies were made available in the staff room. This aimed to increase the exposure to as many staff members as possible while utilising common communication methods for this age group, such as Facebook. The left side of the theory of reasoned action was targeted by the use of information to build on people's current belief system regarding the success of weight loss diets. Change in attitude was assessed through a pre and post test question asking people how successful they believe weight loss diets were in the long term. Just a little bit of housekeeping, some of the session objectives. Hopefully by the end of the session we'll be able to name four different weight loss approaches and identify two reasons why they are less sustainable in the long term and also identify two more sustainable approaches. Okay, so coming back to our learning objectives, some sustainable ways to manage weight loss. So, researchers looked at behaviours that are consistent among people who have successfully lost and maintained their weight loss. And some of these behaviours include